This from Doc Crow, also from a couple weeks ago, getting back to answering these questions. Someone mentioned Sqwirl's recovery timeline as being similar to Bernard's. Does that mean Bernard will be out a long time and take a game or two to get back into the swing of things, or Sqwirl's just recovering nicely from his injury? Bernard's not going to miss any games unless he has some sort of setback. And he could have done way more this spring if not just for them wanting to hold him back more. So, no, it's more of Sqwirl is coming along, I think, maybe perhaps quicker than expected. But I don't think they're even trying to put a timeline on him playing, you know, at this point. I think it's all just like, hey, he's doing well. Let's keep him doing well. And I can't imagine there's too much discussion on, like, what he can or can't do. Or I mean, as far as, like, any expectation for him playing anytime soon, I doubt there's much of that. But they fully expect Bernard to play, like, game one right out of the chutes.
Yeah, for me, I think the recovery timeline part was more having to do with recovery from their particular injury, if that makes sense. So I think Bernard's recovery timeline, he's ahead of, you know, the timeline. I think he's going to play game one. I think he's going to be ready for the fall. He sat out all spring, from what I can tell, mainly precautionary and making sure that he was at full strength when the fall came around. As far as Sqwirl goes, I think it just means that he's doing well in his recovery, and that his timeline is looking very positive. But, you know, everyone loves Sqwirl, and Sqwirl was so special last year and so fun to watch. But I would just urge people to have patience because
Basketball coach is already a failure. Come on now, get with the picture and let's get on to the next thing.
But my point behind that is you don't want Sqwirl to come back and get hurt again. You want to take your time because Baylor needs him at full strength. And if they can ever get a full year out of Sqwirl, that's going to be a really special year from the running back position, whether that's this year or next year. I think it's just really important to exercise some patience because you want him at full strength when he comes back, full confidence, overcome mental hurdles, overcome all of the things that come with serious injuries like this before he's rushed back into action.
Yeah, I mean, I think you just kind of nailed the nailed the hammerhead, whatever.
Yeah.
I don't know. I can't help me out here. You hit the nail on the head. Thank you.
Yeah, there you go. Sorry. Yeah.
There being two different injuries, a shoulder versus an ACL. So, you know, that plays into it. And Bernard had surgery, and I mean, he had it. How much sooner before Sqwirl did? I'm trying to think of even when they both got hurt, which is all fuzzy now.
Bernard was definitely before because Sqwirl got hurt in the Iowa State game, Abram was already starting in that game. Maybe a couple weeks.
Yeah, but again, it was, I mean, different injuries anyway. So, I mean, hopefully Bernard looks as good as he did in the spring just from what little we saw. He looked pretty good and was still just kind of 75% moving along half the time, probably, if even that. And Sqwirl is just nice to see him out there. But, man, after what we saw last time, just no rushing him back. I mean, there's no reason to put him out on the field anytime soon unless he's 100% healthy. Just no reason for it. So maybe we see him next year. Maybe we don't. I don't know. I'm not really worried about it. I just want that kid to get healthy and not have an experience. Like last year, that was just so heartbreaking. It was so heartbreaking, the way he was running. I mean, it's his time, like the rare bright spot in that entire season. And it's like, hey, there's some momentum towards the end of the year. And then just like, bah. Boom. I mean, the worst thing that could have happened. So, rooting for Sqwirl and Bernard to both have healthy years for sure.
Here, I got it. Out of everybody who played defensive back in the spring game, who do you think will have the best career at Baylor overall? Wow. That's a tough one. Do you have a – I guess we're also counting seniors, right, and what they've done already?
Yeah, so I'm sitting here thinking of Raleigh Tejada, Kalen Barnes. You know, the young guys, I don't really know. Like, I don't have much of a – I mean, Lorando Johnson, if we're going off just, like, solely, like, buzz coming out of spring, you know.
But he didn't play in the spring game, so does he count? Or I don't even know. Because he would be high on my list as well.
Yeah, I don't know. Whatever you think to answer it.
I'll say Kalen Barnes, I guess. I think that if he stays another year, he'll be really successful. And as far as a younger guy, Lorando's a good one. I would also probably look at Devin Neal as a potential answer there. I think he showed some flashes of what he could be. So I guess older guy, Kalen Barnes, younger guy, either Lorando Johnson or Devin Neal.
Yeah, I'm excited to see Al Walcott as well, safety. And
I like Devin Lemire, who came in for Lorando because Lorando didn't play in the spring game. I thought he played really well. He had a sack, a couple tackles. I felt like he had a good performance too. So he's another interesting one. Again, that nickel star position is a little weird how you define it, but I guess I'll count him as a DB.
Yeah. So, yeah, I mean, there's a bevy of names, but I don't think anybody just really stands out that much further unless you're going with the older guys who we've kind of seen a lot of already.
Petrie. I mean,
Yeah, which if you count him as, I mean, he is, but he's also kind of a linebacker, so yeah, right, whatever. Yeah. All right, let's see if we can't get, we should be able to get all these in relatively easily. Doc Crow, is the defense right now how Aranda would like schematically, or will we see it change as he recruits his own players rather than using the last staff's recruits?
Yeah, I think the defense
it's his
is
his defense.
Yeah,
at this point. I mean, look at the, you know, look at Apu and bringing him in to solidify that nose tackle. I mean, look at the usage of guys like Petrie and like the hybrid, you know, corner safeties, whether you call it the Jack or the Jack and the
Star.
The Star position, you know, like, I mean, so, I mean, that's his defense. I think that they're about where they are. I just think they would like more of what they have. I think they would like another Apu. I think they would like a good proven couple edge rushers would be good. Gotta love what you have a linebacker and then just depth at safety and at corner. But yeah, that's pretty much, I think, Grayson, what they would like.
Yeah, I think that you might see differences in personnel and maybe how guys look on the field, if that makes sense. I do think at corner, and this is no slight against Raleigh Tejada. He's obviously great, but I think they would rather, recruiting-wise, when you're specifically only looking at recruits, having two Kalen Barnes, you know, right, if they're making that decision there. If you're looking at the linebacker position, Terrel Bernard is unbelievable. Don't get me wrong. He was terrific in high school, but there were knocks on him speed-wise and what he could do as far as athletic upside. Obviously, he's answered all those questions during his career, but I also think if you look at the guys they're recruiting, they're going after more athletic guys and more, you know, faster guys, guys with maybe higher upsides, even though we've seen what Terrel Bernard's been able to do. So I do think that there are going to be differences in maybe what the players look like and how they fit in the defense a little bit. But schematically, as far as this is what we're going to run, I don't see many differences in that. So if you're going to look around at positions, I'd say the Jack is probably the most notable because the only recruit that is really, I guess, his, I suppose, in that room is really Victor Obi. I mean, and that was kind of an early addition. I don't even know if you'd count that for Aranda. So I think that room specifically is one where they're trying to add guys who maybe fit exactly what he wants a little bit more, even though I think he's going to get great production out of the guys that they currently have. So I would say there might be differences in who he recruits, but once again, schematically, how it looks, how they're going to run their defense, it's going to be very, very similar.
What players are going to benefit the most from a full summer to learn plays and build their bodies under Valoria?
Yeah, players that are going to benefit the most. So for this one, I'm going
to young guys. I mean, automatically.
Yeah, young guys get the automatic boost. I would also say big guys get an automatic boost. So guy like Garmin Randolph, who we saw have a really nice spring, I think his body's just going to continue to grow. I was really high on him as a recruit when he came in, and I just think you're seeing him. His body just needed to transform. He's kind of that BJ Thompson mold, but he's actually been able to put weight on and be able to keep the weight. So Garmin is one I'm really, really excited about. Like you said, a lot of the young guys are obviously going to get bigger and get stronger. But he's probably the one that I look at and go, man, he could have a huge summer leading into the spring. And then, yeah, all the freshmen, obviously, are going to put a ton of weight on and get a lot stronger.
Yeah, I mean, that's going to be kind of like if you ask that question next year and the year after, it's going to be the same answer. The young guys and the guys who need to change their bodies. I mean, that's what the offseason's for. So, yeah, that's who will benefit. I think Lorando Johnson, like, Aranda and staff land a difference maker via transfer on the O-line.
Yes, that's definitely going to happen. And people keep saying it's not going to happen or don't expect it to happen. It's going to happen. They're going to land at least one transfer, maybe two. It's just going to happen. I think they'll be quality. I think they're going to get a starter at right tackle and potentially a starter at guard.